Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to do with the last novel, 4.4, The Sign of Four, written by Sir Arthur Ignatius Conan Doyle. He is a British writer and he is the one who has created the character of Sherlock Holmes. The Sign of Four is a second novel of Sir Arthur, in which Sherlock Holmes and his partner, Dr. Watson, try to solve the mystery of the hidden treasure and murder. Now let's try to understand the outline of the novel. The novel begins like this, in which Dr. Watson and Sherlock Holmes, they are having a discussion. In between, a young lady named Mary Mostyn, she enters and tells them that her father had disappeared some 10 years ago. And after that, she had received an advertisement asking her to give her address, which she sent. And from then on, she has been receiving a large pearl in the mail on the same day of every year. Every year, she has been receiving that pearl. And she has been asked to come at a certain place, okay, Lyceum Theatre. There is an instruction in the letter asking her to come over there, and the letter also gives her some hint that some injustice has been done to her, so she immediately needs to come over, and she's been instructed not to bring the police. So that's the reason why she has gone to Sherlock Holmes asking his help. Now the three of them have gone to Lyceum Theatre in a carriage, and they have been led into a very strange house. And in that house there is an eccentric man named Thaddeus Sholto, and he tells her that Mary's father has died, and in that way she is the heir to a great hidden treasure. Now Thaddeus tells that how his father has always lived in the fear of this men, he being attacked with some attacked by men of wooden legs. Okay, now on the deathbed he has told his sons about the existence of the hidden treasure, and before that he tells that this share, a partial share has to be given to Miss Mary as well. But then when he is just narrating all the incident, the story, he happens to see a bearded man at the window, and then he suffers a heart attack and he dies. So the next morning he finds near the body, there is a note fixed on the body which read as the sign of four. Now Thaddeus also tells that his brother Bartholomew has discovered this hidden treasure, and as a father had said that this treasure has to be divided between you two and the lady named Mary Mostyn. Thaddeus now takes them to the Sholto estate. Okay, at the estate they find the housekeeper, who happens to be a little shaken, and he tells that Bartholomew has not been seen since he's been locked in the room for a long time and he's not been seen. So what Holmes does is he sees through the keyhole and he finds an unnatural grinning face, grinning meaning smiling face, but then he has been poisoned with a dart. Okay, so he's killed. When they open the door, they find that he has a poison thorn lodged at his neck, so he's been killed. Then he investigates, Mr. Sherlock Holmes investigates and concludes that it must be done by the wooden leg man. Okay, he must be the one. And then there is one more person who is involved in it. And these persons have left with the treasure, the Agra treasure. Now, Mr. Holmes has said that the wooden leg man stepped in creosote during his escape. The wooden leg man in creosote. Creosote is a paint. So he's a wooden leg man. That wooden leg is painted. Now what Sherlock Holmes does is he borrows a dog, okay, so that the dog can follow the scent. And the dog leads them to the Thames River. Now, they conclude that the criminals must have hired a boat, and over the next few days, what Holmes does is he hires the street urchins. Street urchins, they are the young children who are dressed, poorly dressed. Okay, and with all the efforts, they come to know that he has fled in the boat that is named as the Aurora, has been camouflaged. The boat had been camouflaged, meaning it must be painted so that they could not recognize the boat. Okay, it would be painted or colored so that it makes it difficult to recognize. And the same night, Holmes, Watson and several other officers, they go behind the Aurora, that's the boat, in the police barge. Police barge is a long narrow boat, police boat. Okay, and they overtake the boat, and in that they find the wooden legged captain and a small pygmy. Pygmy, they are the dwarfs from the Andaman Islands. Now, before they could catch hold of them, the natives try to shoot Holmes with a blowpipe. You know, that's a technique of attacking using the dart. Okay, so but then Holmes and Watson, they try to catch hold of the legged man, wooden legged man, and now the Aurora runs into the ground, and subsequently the wooden legged man also cannot run because his leg has got stuck in the mud, and they are captured. And they come to know that the wooden legged man, his name is Jonathan Small, and he is brought back to Baker Street. He is having that iron box which they found on the boat. And now Small, that is Jonathan Small, he goes to tell the story of the Agra treasure. Then he says that he was, when he was stationed as a fortress gatekeeper in India. Fortress is actually, it's a big castle or a strong building which makes it difficult to attack. Okay, so he was a gatekeeper out there. Small explains that he was approached by three Arab guards and they offered a share. So now he became a little greedy. They offered a share in the great fortune if Small would help him murder the man who's carrying the treasure. So Small had tried to block the man who carried the treasure. Okay, so when the man, an emissary from the wealthy sheikh, arrived, emissary is a person who's come for a special task. Okay, so now the man is being blocked by Small, and the Arabs murder him, and they've got the treasure. Now the four conspirators hid the treasure and soon after, but although they hid it, they were actually captured and arrested for the murder of the emissary. Now Small is being sent to a penal colony. Penal colony, it's a place or a settlement. It could be like a jail. Okay, there he's been sent because he has committed the murder, and there he tries to befriend a native called Tonga, who's become his loyal companion. So Small has bribed both of these guards, Sholto and Mostyn, into helping him escape, and in exchange they would give him the share of the fortune. Now Sholto has gone to bring the treasure. After some time, Small recognizes that Sholto has betrayed him and he has escaped with the treasure along with Tonga. Then after many years, Small has been able to track where Sholto is, and that is the time where Sholto is lying at his death bed. Okay, and he looks at the window. Sholto is standing. Small is at the window. Sholto looks at him, and he suffers a heart attack, and he dies. So next morning, you find a small note over the body, fixed over the body, and it has a reference to himself. Himself, that is Sholto and the three Arabs. So that is this. That's how the sign of four. And then when they go to the Sholto estate, that's where they find that Tonga has murdered Bartholomew, and the two-legged man and Tonga, they both have stolen the treasure and gone. Then finally, Small has, in the end, they conclude how he has thrown the treasure overboard, meaning he has thrown it out of the ship into the water. And then finally, Small is taken to the prison. And Watson now proposes to Mary Mostyn, who is in love with her. Okay, this is how the story ends. I hope you must have understood till here. Thank you.